Hi everyone, Chef Vermaak Doors in the Low Countries. Now here you see an Intex above ground pool. This pool is 9.5 meters by 5 meters, so it's a very large one, and we have it already for quite some time, already for 16 years, from 2006 up to now 2022 we had this pool. It has been used a lot, especially when the children were very small, but now it's time to take it out and remove it. And yeah, of course, we're going to do this the Kubota way. The actual reason why I'm now removing the whole swimming pool is because the salt water system is now giving an error, low salt. And I'm very sure that the salt in the water is not low. So this is a breakdown of the measurement electronics of this Intex salt water system. But it happens every 4 years approximately. Then you typically see that you get these types of errors when you're very sure that that's not the case. And that's also the reason why I'm now going to take out the swimming pool, because I don't want to replace the salt water system again, because the swimming pool is not used as much as it has been in the past. So the first thing is to remove all this supporting materials and then remove the liner using the Kubota. Now inside the liner there is this metal tube that is supported by these metal beams. And I'm very sure that this is all very corroded, as you can see also there, so it will be difficult to take it out. I will use the front loader for that, and the first thing I will try is to go in with the ripper, try to lift it up, see what happens.
The Intex pool liner can easily be penetrated by the sharp point of the Rhino ripper. But when driving backwards, the liner is still so strong that the compact tractor is lifted at the rear side, even with the heavy box blade mounted at the back. The liner is therefore penetrated again at another location and ripped apart piece by piece. The Rhino ripper is a homemade tool designed for easy tree stump removal by ripping the roots of the tree. It is designed for the front loader of a compact tractor using the quick attach interface. The link above shows a video explaining how this tool is designed and built. For removal of other type of structures, the Rhino ripper is a handy implement as well. Here you see me removing the metal standing poles one by one in order to remove them first. After removal of these metal bars, I can again penetrate the liner with the ripper without the risk of damaging the compact tractor by these metal poles bending and moving around while moving forward into the pool.
The cat always has to move onto the Kubota. Don't know why. Orange attracts orange, I think. So we'll use a Stanley knife to remove the liner from the metal carrying structure, from the metal supporting structure, so I can remove all the metal and separate it from the liner. So have you ever seen a Kubota driving straight through a pool? Well, if not, watch this. So now the next step is to cut the liner into small pieces so it's easily transportable using the pellet forks on the front loader.
The pellet forks is also a homemade device. This pellet forks implement can be mounted to the front loader with the quick attach interface as well as to the backside 3-point hitch. The link at the top of the screen shows the video of the design and manufacturing of this implement. And here you see another homemade implement in this video, the rake digger. In this case it is being used to lift the remaining parts of the liner and ground sheet so it can be cut to smaller pieces easily. The rake digger has very strong and long teeth designed for deep digging, loosening ground, rock removal and raking. More information on the design and how it is built can be found in the link above.
So as you can see, it's now completely cleaned out. The intakes above ground pool is completely removed. With the blocks blade, I already did some preliminary planing, but need to do that more properly. Next phase is now to plant it in again, make a new project out of that, but that's the next step. We've had the intake spool for 16 years. The liner was still okay, by the way, so it was not a problem to have it even longer, but I didn't want to have yet again another salt water device, so I thought it's time to go. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. See you next time.